my channel. My name is Brittany Bundles, and today's video is going to be going over when to, or how to know when to extend a sale. I'm going to be recording this in my car. It is raining, so I'm sure you're going to hear the rain falling. I apologize if it bothers you. But I just got done recording a video and I wanted to go ahead and do the next video while I'm already out here. So yeah, I decided to go ahead and do it. Now, the reason that I'm making this video is because I have gotten questions as to if I'm going to be extending my fall sale. And I was thinking about it, you know, I was like, should I extend it? Should I not extend it? And I was going through the process of elimination in my own mind. You know, I had a section over here that was like, okay, the reasons that you should extend it, and a section of my mind over here, like the reasons you shouldn't. And I really, you know, the reasons that I should definitely outweighed the reasons that I shouldn't. And I started thinking about, you know, what are some good things to outline as far as when you should extend a sale, because I don't believe that every sale should be extended. Some people extend sales because they forgot that it was going on, and by the time they remember, you know, maybe a customer had already purchased, so they go along with it. It's kind of like when you're dancing on stage and you miss a step. No one else really knows that you missed the step, so you keep on going with it. Nothing wrong with that at all. Some people extend it because they're hoping to get more sales, and they didn't do as good as they intended to do. I mean, people extend sales for a variety of reasons. One thing that is definitely true in any industry is that different businesses do different things to get different results. That's why it's so challenging to coach specifically to a certain formula that's going to work 100% of the time to everyone, because there is no such thing. There are some businesses that will say never extend a sale, some businesses that say always extend a sale, and you'll have me that says, you know, it depends on that specific situation. So in this video, I'm going to be going over some things that I jotted down in regards to when to extend a sale, to see if, you know, this is something that you can apply to your business. If you are looking for specific tailored information for your business, I strongly recommend you getting a consultation. My email address is across the screen, so if you do want a consultation, feel free to email me or click the link down below to my website. The consultation service is available through my website as well. So let me go ahead and pull up my notes here. It is really coming down now. Okay, so the first thing that I want to talk about is requests. So if you are getting lots of requests or multiple requests to extend your sale, it may be a good thing to do so. You may want to consider it at least. Initially, I wasn't considering extending the sale. I planned on having the sale go for about a week or a week and a half, but I did not plan to extend it after it ended. It's supposed to end tonight, and I have decided to extend it. So if you are interested in the fall sale, go over to my website. I'll put the website across the screen and take a look for yourself to see if there's any products or services that you're interested in. But request. Now, if you are getting customers that are emailing you, texting you, customers that have DM'd you, left comments under your post when you promoted your sale as to, hey, you know, is there a possibility that you're going to be extending the sale? I know this sale ends tonight. Would the discount work if I put it in on Tuesday, because I don't get paid until Tuesday, or I don't get paid until this Thursday, or I don't get paid until Friday? Is there a way that you can save this discount for me? And if you get multiple requests, typically if it's not going to hurt your business, and we're going to get into that later on in the video, then it may be something that you may want to do. But it's not, you know, it's not in stone yet. Just because you get someone or some people that are asking if you're going to extend the sale doesn't mean that you necessarily should, because I've also extended sales in the past, and you know, customers have come and they've asked, you know, hey, are you going to extend the sale? And I've extended it, and those customers ended up not buying. So you don't want to base your decision 100% on requests, but I would say that requests, it's like, that's kind of like the first inkling that I would start considering extending a sale that I had already pretty much planned on stopping on a specific date. Now, I do say this also, everything in business, nothing is really etched in stone. There's always those one-offs, and there's always different things that you may want to consider. So keep your options open and listen to your customers. That's really something that can benefit your business. Now, when I say listen to your customers, I don't mean take everyone's advice and change up everything that you have going for your business. Ultimately, you still have to make the best decision for your business and your goal and your brand. However, there are some business owners that don't listen to their customers or clients or potential customers at all. And that can definitely have a negative impact. Listening to your customers, replying to the request, even if the reply is, you know, thank you for reaching out. Unfortunately, we're not extending this sale. However, make sure that you sign up for our mailing list so that when we do offer our next sale, maybe in a month or two, you are going to be one of the first to be alerted. Even if the reply is something like that, it still acknowledges the request. So if you get requests, again, like I mentioned, that should be, in my opinion, the first, kind of like the first sign that can, you know, prompt you to start thinking, should I go ahead and extend this or not? You know, the second tip that I have is make sure that you're not overlapping or interfering with future planned sales. So if I had a sale, for example, that was going to be starting 2 weeks from now, then I wouldn't have extended the fall sale. Why? It really doesn't make sense for my business. I try not to have sales back to back. Why? Because you don't really want your customers getting used to you offering sales all the time. Now, there's really no specific rhythm that you have to go on. Every business is different, but you want your sales to be something that your customers look forward to. You want your sales to be something that you can build anticipation toward. And if you're always offering sales, then it kind of takes away that excitement. It kind of takes that away, that urgency. Even though some people may say, no, it doesn't. You know, I do it all the time and people still are excited. Maybe, but I guarantee if you took it off the table as much, you may notice a different result, because your sale, if you're going to offer the sale price all the time, then it might as well just be your standard price. You know, a sale is supposed to be something in all industries that brings more customers in, brings more clients in, because they have that small window of opportunity to save more than they typically do. Now, if you're already promoting on the value, if you're already promoting on the quality of your product and the benefit that your product is going to provide to your customers, you really don't have to worry about selling based off the price. You don't have to worry about promoting your prices all the time. And so the fact that you're not always offering sales really won't have a negative impact on your business. Companies that only promote the sale, companies that only promote the low pricing, may be thinking like, you know, a sale is all I do. That's all I do to get customers to come in. But like I said, if you're promoting on the right principles and the right foundation and the right value of your business, then you really don't have to worry about, are my prices low or are they not? You'll be able to keep your business moving and keep your customers excited and happy, even when you're not offering a sale. I've made multiple videos on that. So if you do want more information about that, be sure to go to my hair business playlist and check out some of my videos there. Because like I've mentioned, I've made multiple videos about that. So make sure that your sales are not overlapping. Again, if you are planning on having a sale in the next few weeks, you may not want to extend. I always recommend in the beginning of the year to go ahead and plan and strategize, or even right before the beginning of the year, what type of sales you're going to be offering. That way, you don't have to quickly decide and quickly at the spur of the moment plan out what kind of sales you're going to offer. Everything's already planned. You have a strategic plan for your whole business that year. And of course, like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, nothing's really written in stone. You always can change different things. You know, you're the creator of your business, you know, so you have the ability to switch up some things if it makes sense for you. However, that would be another thing that I would kind of look at. Are these sales overlapping? Am I able to extend this sale without really pushing it into another sale? Have I checked my discounts? Because sometimes if you are like using a certain e-commerce site, for example, with Shopify, Shopify gives you the option to pretty much decide, like you have a calendar inside of your discount section where you can start your discounts on a certain day and end them on a certain day. So you want to check all of them. You don't have Shopify, and if you're interested, click the link down below. Get started. You know, there may even be a free trial, but you have to click that link to see. But you want to check that out too, because in a few videos ago, I talked about making sure that your discount codes aren't, you know, if you don't want them stacking up on each other, make sure that your discount ends when it's supposed to end. So, you know, you don't want something to happen where you're extending the sale, but then you already have another sale discount ready to go next week. And so, you know, it's just, it just makes things a lot more confusing, and you may end up losing more money than you anticipated. So always make sure that it's not going to interfere with your initial business plan or your current business plan by extending the sale. Now, the next tip that I have is increased orders. So if you've noticed during the current sale that you're offering that you're getting an increase in orders, and say you haven't had the time to go to the post office, or you're getting an increase of orders, so you're behind on packaging because you know you have more orders than you typically have, setting the right expectation, like we mentioned in a lot of videos, will definitely take you that extra mile in customer service and in building relationships with your customers. Typically, customers and clients aren't mad for no reason. Now, some people will, you know, people are people, but a lot of times they're mad for a reason. You know, they're mad because their expectations were let down in a lot of circumstances. If you Google different customer service scenarios, not even just in the hair industry, a lot of people have the complaint of, you know, hey, I purchased this and on the website it said it would be here tomorrow and it's not, or hey, they said this on the website and it's not. So it's a matter of setting the right expectation. So if you already have on your website the right expectation regarding your sale, that it's going to take maybe 7 to 10 business days, 5 to 10 business days, 3 to 5, whatever the case may be, and you let your customers know that it's because of your sales, you know, extended shipping or delayed shipping because of, you know, your sale, a lot of customers would definitely understand that. So you want to make sure that that's something that you are taking into consideration too. If it makes sense for you, if it's going to be more convenient for you to go ahead and extend your sale to give you more time to get caught up on the orders and also more orders to come through, so that when you do go to the post office, you don't have to make as many trips. You can just kind of, you know, go ahead and do it. Then I would definitely say extend it. You know what I mean? Give yourself that time so that you're not feeling like you have to rush right after the sale. You know, you have to do all of this. Give yourself time, and you may want to extend the sale a little bit further until you get time to catch up on the orders. And even while you're getting caught up on the orders, you may also get more orders coming in, but still, it gives you more time to kind of get back on track. So, like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, some companies use the extended sale because they forgot it was up or they can't go to the post office. Whatever the case may be, extending the sale is going to work great for your customers and also for you, especially those customers that are looking for a price break. The customers that are looking for their hair like tomorrow or in the next 3 days may not be as happy about the extended sale. However, more than likely, you're going to have more customers that are more appreciative for the extended sale. They're not, you know, so, and not only will it allow you to have time to get caught up on orders, but it also may help to increase those orders. Like I mentioned, even if it, you know, you're getting caught up on the orders, it still will give you some time to go ahead and generate more orders, you know, make more money and also ship out, you know, more products for those customers that are interested. Now, the next tip that I have in regards to when should you extend sales is if it makes financial sense. Some people have sales and they did not position the sales correctly. We talk about this so often and we're probably going to keep talking about it because it still happens and it's very common. But some people have sales where it doesn't really make much financial sense. You know, maybe during the sales, they're getting orders, but after every order, they're getting maybe like a $5 profit off of every order, or maybe they're getting a $3 profit, or maybe they're not getting any profit. Maybe they're actually losing money because they didn't structure it the right way. If you have a sale that you didn't structure the right way, but you've already promoted it and advertised it, and you've decided that you're going to just eat the cost because it was an error on your side, I wouldn't recommend extending the sale. You know, if it's something that's going to hurt your business and it doesn't make financial sense, I would go ahead and make sure that you are ending the sale when you say you're going to end the sale. Because it, like I said, it doesn't make financial sense. If you have a specific goal to make for your business for this whole year, and let's say for the sale, you already knew that you were going to take a huge loss, or you weren't going to get as big of a profit because you're doing a sale and maybe your orders aren't as consistent, so you're not really getting a big profit, and it's going to interfere with your end of the year goals, and you know that you've been selling off the value, so even if you remove the sale, you're still going to have customers and clients, it may not make the most financial sense for you to keep the sale going. Now, if it's if you're in a different boat where you're like, you know, hey, I structured my sale the right way, I'm not getting as much because I'm discounting my products, but because I'm getting more orders due to the sale, it makes up for the money that I discounted and more because I'm getting much more orders than I typically would because of the sale, or I'm getting orders a lot sooner than I typically would because of the sale. Then it may make sense to go ahead and extend it. If it's not going to hurt your business, if it's actually going to help your business financially to keep the sale going, then I recommend keeping it going. But only you will know that. So there's not like a one size fits all, unfortunately. And that's why I do so many consultations, because even though I gave advice on YouTube, this advice is general. It's general advice. And it, you know, everyone has a whole different business structure, a completely different business plan. You can have literally 10 women and 10 men selling the exact same product, but have completely different business Structures, completely different business goals, completely different business models, completely different interactions with their customers. And so they all have a completely different outcome. So it truly just depends on what's going to work best for you. Not every company that's offering a sale is profiting from that sale. Some people have a high gross amount that they've made this year and their net is not so high. So you just want to make sure that everything is balancing out and making sure that it makes financial sense, meaning that it's not putting you back. It's actually helping your business grow, would definitely be a recommendation. And then the last thing that I would recommend is, are you willing and able to promote the extension of the sale? Now, when you promote your sales, especially when you start to build up your email mailing list, you may not have to do as much to promote sales. Before I had an email mailing list, before I had my following on social media, I had to do a lot more than I am doing now to promote on social media. I actually even spent more money, and I learned that there's other ways to promote without spending tons of money to do so. And I've made multiple videos about that too. And those videos are also in my hair business and business playlist. So check them out when you get a moment. But you should definitely consider promoting. If no one's going to know that you're extending the sale except the 5 customers that maybe reached out to you via email and asked, are you extending? You're not really being fair to all of your other customers. You want as many people as possible to know that you're extending the sale. It's going to help your business if you structured it correctly to make financial sense. And it's also going to help your customers with the discounted amount for the products that they love and or services that they love, you know. So make sure that you are willing to promote it. Now, when you promote it, doesn't mean that you have to promote it 5 times a day. It doesn't mean that you have to spam everyone's email. I mean, letting them know in a newsletter the day that your discount is supposed to end would definitely suffice, or letting them know the next day after your sale was supposed to end will definitely work as well. Maybe putting a story on your social media, letting some of your customers know that have reached out to you personally, like maybe via text on your business line or email or, you know, whatever the case may be, letting them know that, hey, I decided to extend the sale will also, sorry, I saw a little fly, will also be a good, you know, practice and habit to get into. So those are some things that I will look into in regards to should I extend sales or when should you extend sales. I have to decide what's going to work best for you, like I say all the time. If you do want assistance, reach out to me. I'm more than happy to help. But sales should not be something that you're doing every single day, in my opinion. It should definitely be something that you're thinking about carefully and that you're not using too often, because like I've mentioned before, if you use it too often, it can definitely take away some of the excitement and some of the success that your sales would have had if you used them strategically instead of continuously. So I really hope that this video helped. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.